Hey guys, John Luxley here, back with our blind playthrough of Dark Souls 3. Kapow! Alright. Yep. Man, I still... Well... I was gonna say, I still hear the thing, but I sat at the... Oh, right! Sat at the bonfire, so it's like, yeah, it makes sense that I would hear that thing it respond, but you know, shouldn't be active yet. Let's just run back here, fill up our focus, and then run up there. And then see what happens in here. I'm already... We got a little bit of a glimpse earlier, and that's gonna be fun. That's yeah, it's gonna be wonderful. Oh jeez. Okay, so let's scope it out. Dude at the top. I know there's another one over there. But that's like the two-handed guy that we just fought. With the lightning sword or whatever. And then there's one of those buff guys over there. And then... As far as I can tell, that's another buff guy and another Lothric knight. And I think... I don't actually think that's it, but that's all I saw. I'd be willing to wager there's more. Okay, that's one. Oh, hey. Okay, can I backstab? No, you blocked. Ah, oh, crap. Whoa! Oh, good. Man, how do they recover so quickly? Well, okay, he caught on. Oh, jeez. Oh, you dick. Okay, so I gotta... Oh, no, I should have done it. I have to take out that other guy, because otherwise it's gonna be a bad time. Oh my gosh! What is going on? Okay, well... At least he's slower. Too bad he's buffed, though. That's a real pain. And that hurt, of course, a lot. No! Well. Right. Wolnir's crown. That looked like an interesting description there. Something about all the different lords. All the different lords were bequeathed crowns, but bequeathed by whom? That's kind of weird, isn't it, right? Like, who would bequeath a lord a crown? It sounds like a... It almost sounds like a Lord of the Rings type stuff. And then it says something like, Wolnir got all the other crowns and turned them into dust. From then on, there was only one crown or something. That guy's coming already. Well, that's no good, because now we're going to have to fight two of those buffer dudes. Oh, you and your... Let me backstab you. Ugh, I gotta take out the other guy. The other guy's gonna buff. Okay, well. Oh, holy crap! Oh no! Oh, that's no good. Oh, you. There's the other buff. Yeah, thanks, jerk. Okay, well. Wow. Right on. These guys are dangerous. And then the camera spins around and that doesn't help. That's part of the problem, like when you're really close. The camera gets all freaky. Man! They have poise. They have lots of poise. Yeah, and when the camera gets all freaky, the controls turn or change so that the camera, I don't know. It's just weird. You guys know what I'm talking about though, I'm sure. It's okay. Well, that was rough. There's still that guy. But at least the two buff, you know. Like, what do you call them? Like, what's the MMO term for, guys that buff other guys? I mean, I feel like buff isn't, Oh, you jerk. Oh, you come on, man. Man, I'm just... so much Estus that I'm using. Give me Estus back. Lothric Knight Great Shield. I believe I've gotten that, but let's just double check. Maybe not. Great Shield of the renowned Lothric Knights, decorated with a holy symbol. I can't make out what the symbol appears to be. The knights who formed the High Priestess's Guard carried great shields such as these, which were granted high magic absorption through her blessing. Let's see. So what is their magic? 83? Wait, have I not gotten a crest shield that is good against magic? No, I've gotten lightning, dark, fire. But not magic itself. That's annoying. Which is even worse because I think the crest shield was originally a magic shield. At least in the first Dark Souls. Well, okay. Well, all right. That was a rough little area. I mean, you know, it probably shouldn't be. Ember, or you know, probably isn't to most people. Or maybe it is. I don't know. Doesn't really make sense that that would be broken right there. I'm just, you know, just saying a little bit. Seriously, if that's a obscure, and then I took an arrow in the knee reference, I'm just gonna cry a little bit. I don't think it is. It wouldn't make sense, but who knows? Who knows? I don't even know, you know, how did that even become a meme? I mean, I know it was a, like a Skyrim thing, like the guard just mentions, oh, I was an adventurer and then I took an arrow in the knee, and it's like, okay. It's just something said once and then all of a sudden the internet just latches onto it. Okay. Okay. Okay, boss door. I was like, okay, so that's Prince Lothric. And then I see the quote-unquote angel wings, which looks a lot like the Bed of Chaos. I'm just like, oh. I mean, it still could be Prince Lothric. It's possible. I would really hope. I mean, you know, it would be nice if there was a bonfire. That way I wouldn't have to go through all that crap. But, I mean, you know. It sounds like there is one, actually. Or maybe that's just those torches. And also, since it continues that way, I would expect this to be an optional boss. Kind of like the, an elevator, okay. Sunlight metal. I don't think we've gotten one of those. An optional boss, kind of like, the old Demon King. No, I haven't gotten one. Medal received for victory in co-op. Medal received by members of the Warrior of Sunlight Covenant for victory over the final foe when summoned. The summoner also gains the same medal. The medal engraved with the holy symbol of the sun is slightly warm and reminds one of the great honor of a shared victory. Actually, really, a door. I'm really glad they didn't bring out the whole jolly cooperation thing. That's, you know. Oh. Okay. Okay. See, there was another dragon. That's right. And I was like, okay, so is there another pus thing? The answer is yes. So there's a ladder up there. Treasure ahead. Guess we'll find out. Gotta scope it out real fast. Oh, that's no good. There are guys over there. I just saw the blood first. That was what I first saw. Okay, so then, yes, there is a dude. You know, there was something, like, there was that hanging guy from above, so probably down there is where it's, where it was. That other, another dude like this. Titanite chunk, right on. Okay, now what? I can't believe that there's all these bloodstains from just those two guys. Oh, crap. Well, that's what you get for not paying attention, I suppose. They're archers. And an axe-wielding dude. Okay, he's poisoned, so that's good. Can I backstab? Wow! Whoa! Whoa! And one of them looks different than the other. don't know if I killed the other one too, but whatever, he's down there. I think he's dead. That looks like the corpse. Okay, well, you know, so there was that. This is a different area. And that is a ladder. Okay. Pointless ahead, therefore visions of fury. What, you're talking about the treasure or over there? Or both? Gotta check the ceilings, gotta check the floors and stuff. I don't know. No illusion ahead. You're right. You are correct. I mean, you could have just not said anything, though. But whatever, I'm fine. Okay, so the question is, what is that? Okay, and I see some dude fighting down there. And I hear enemies. See that one. But where are the enemies in here? Knight's Ring. Let's check this out. Increases strength. Ring engraved with the portrait of a knight increases strength. In Lothric, the knight has long been considered one of the three pillars of the king's rule, and thus were allowed to rear dragons. So are they just calling the dragons... are they calling drakes dragons? Because, I mean, I thought dragons were extinct. Even the ones that we saw, I think those are drakes. But who knows? I'm trying to see up. Try luring out and then ladder. The ladder strategy is not bad, I suppose. And is there... am I going to get shot or something? Is that what the deal is? Why is that one just hanging out right there? Because the rest of them are flying. That one's just chilling. Right. Ah, man. Oh my God. Right. I mean, it helps the denial of tears or whatever. But if he's going on a spree, man. I mean, I feel, you know, maybe a little bit pathetic for wanting a another bonfire, but man. You know, there's also the whole wait, which one was lightning? Spirit's tree. This would probably help. It's like, yeah, I don't get the soul. Okay. Okay, you just stay there. I don't get the soul bonus. But, see, come on, man. You gotta... oh! Oh, come on! Oh, and I... the camera thing is really annoying. It's like, just spin. Just turn. Just stay always behind me. You know? Like, that was better. That was fine. That was a good hit. Okay, that hurt. Man, and I'm dead again. I wonder if this one is more frustrating to play as like a block, or not a blocker, like a dodger, someone that dual hands a like a big weapon. I feel like it would be, just because these guys seem so... They just feel really cheap. You know, the whole, the whole rule... It's not a rule, but the way it was designed, at least the first one, was that, you know, weak guys would be really quick and not do very much damage and attack in mobs and stuff. You know, and the big ones would be typically slow. You know, I understand it doesn't always have to be that way, but you have the thieves that I fought that were, you know, fast and did a lot of damage. I feel like that should have been a backstab, but okay. And then you have this guy that does a ton of damage. Doesn't seem to stop. And then you have the camera that freaks out a little bit and is generally kind of a pain. Hey, you know, it's good. I mean, I'm not... I can't complain to... Oh, you dick. Oh, you... Yeah, and then it's like you stagger. And I wonder if the stagger thing is... Jesus Christ. I wonder if the stagger thing is based on a stat. Thank you for the Estus. That makes me feel a little bit better. You know, it wouldn't surprise me at all if the stagger was based on, well, poise or something. It's just kind of frustrating. You see these dudes, and you stagger them a little bit. Come on, man. You know, I get staggered, it takes a second. You know, a second to unstagger. But then you have these guys, and they, you know, half a second. And maybe it's poise. I mean, that's a possibility, but... I feel like once you're staggered, like, poise, I thought was preventing stagger, not... I don't know. Kind of like the getting headshot with an arrow in DS2, and how you basically got staggered for like 3 seconds, 4 seconds, something like that. Like, it was bad. It was bad. I want to see what that is. It's almost guaranteed to be a, you know what? Let's see where the elevator goes. Try rear. I don't know what that means, but okay. Yeah, I don't remember what my train of thought was. The whole Bed of Chaos homage boss. What? Why would I want to come back here? I mean, that's a legitimate question. Like, you just go up those stairs and I think there's another bonfire. It's like, why? What's the point of this elevator? You know, there's a bonfire, like, right there. So I fight four dudes and I come up here, or I fight, I guess two dudes. Or maybe I can skip the thing altogether and, I mean, I guess it's a shortcut. I could probably run past those guys and try the boss. I mean, but, and this is gonna be locked. Because I know it's that dude on the other side, right? You know, the guy that killed me the last time. And since we're on it, switch to the fire, I suppose. Block more of these guys. Where does that other one come from, anyway? Oh, he's just hanging out right there. Ouch. Whoa, I don't know how those arrows are missing me, to be honest, but... You know, it's all right. Whoa! I'll take it. Yeah, I'm tempted to try the whole... Yeah, see, I feel like the camera should have flipped around, but... Well, then again, I guess it lets you do what you want when you're just running. It's only when you're locked on, so maybe it's a problem with the lock-on. So there's the door. What is on the other side of this guy? Hopefully not more enemies, but I would expect there to be some. Hey, good job. I mean, with the... You know. Okay, that did hurt a lot. Whoa! Hey, mister, watch out. Oh, you. Oh, you. F me. Whoa. So I'm trying to mitigate the camera thing with waggling the stick a little bit when I... Ouch. Okay, well... When the camera spins around. Ow, 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 ow. That was a good one. Yep, I'll take that little hit. I don't want to do that one, but, you know, whatever. Large Titanite Shard. No, so when the guy, when, you know, I'm trying to spin around and the camera is lagging behind. I'm kind of like waggling the stick left and forth a little bit. It seems to work a little bit as far as... because I think what's happening is the camera is turning and it's altering how you... like how the controls are, but it's not... I don't know. It just feels... oh, okay. Mimic? No, probably not. Nope. More Titanite scales. Okay. Time for Praise the Sun. Yep. Yes. I mean, yes as in, like, yeah, of course. You know, that's... is that the exact statue from DS2? Offer sunlight metal. If I do, what is it? What does it do? Pray at altar of sunlight. Read message. I'll switch back to my shield of want first off. Oh yeah, the stability on that is way worse than my, wow, even the Black Knight shield is only 60. That's a little surprising. Obviously, the Great Shield of Glory is probably the best with a stability of 80, but yeah, strength of 40. So that makes sense. I mean, I only have the one sunlight medal. I guess you give it the sunlight medal and that's what gives you the covenant? Or do I already have the covenant? I do. Okay, so I don't need to do it then. So, like, I mean, this thing is obviously the statue from DS1 or 2, but it doesn't make sense that it would be here because it's inside. Like, I mean, look, right? This table is wood and it's fully... it's not rotted away. It's not broken. Not anymore. And, you know, but this is stone. I mean, I guess they could have grabbed it and moved it from somewhere, but it just seems... I don't know, it doesn't belong. I get that this is a homage. So, that's fine. But it just doesn't fit. Alright. So let's fight that thing. This is gonna hurt when I fall, I suspect. Do I want to use firebombs? And the answer is maybe. Okay. Right. Right. Ah, crap. Do not. Am I... okay, ouch, ouch, quickly, move, or something, move. Did I kill it? I guess so. Titanite chunk ember. Large Titanite shard. So, oh, that's why, because it gives you this. Soul of a Crestfallen Knight. All of that just for... that seems... well... kind of silly. I suppose... wait. Oh, here you go. And a mimic. Okay, so this is the real reason. This is the real reason. Okay. Alright, so we got more barrels and such. Braille Divine Tome of Lothric. Well, Sorry, lady, you're gone. That makes me feel bad, too. I feel like I've messed up. And maybe that's the... You know, I think I mentioned that I'm curious if there's, like, multiple... Like, not just two endings, but, like, multiple endings. So maybe normally you're supposed to screw up, you know? You give her the tome, and then you have her read from it. I'm assuming that's what that does, because of what someone mentioned. And, that causes her to disappear or something, and then, you know, your hollowing's all maxed out, and you didn't do the dark sigil, but you didn't do anything bad, like give the eyes of the firekeeper to the firekeeper, I guess. And so maybe there's a neutral ending, or a, you know, the flame fades. Whereas I suppose, by giving the eyes, maybe it's like, yeah, we're gonna snuff out the flame. I don't know. I'm sure we're gonna see. A sacred braille tome from Lothric filled with miracles for use by knights. Give to a storyteller to learn Lothric miracles. It is said no paladin inside Lothric Castle could fall, owing to the divine protection they enjoyed. So this is probably that, like what those guys were using to buff their weapons. And yeah, I know. Wait, what is... Wait. Did I miss that? Are you serious? Like I'm... Oh, no. That's from the dude falling from up there. Okay. I mean, we can run back and get that, but that's the, that's probably just a large Titanite shard or something. Like, just a large Titanite shard. It's probably... It's not a key item, is what I'm saying. It's a monster, of course. I could tell by the chain. I like how the first one that I encountered in, the wall or whatever, it was like the lighting on it was off. So it's, they're, you know, they're giving you a hint that, you know, it's something not quite right. Oh, don't kick. Don't kick it. It doesn't want to know. Oh, no. Whoa. Okay, we just got to, yep. Oh, whoa, that was a close one. Right on. Okay. Sunlight straight sword. What is this? Let's see. Broken straight sword. We didn't look at this one. Straight sword with a broken blade, a weapon with no exceptional qualities. Only a mad hollow would choose to fight with this. I've probably gotten it before, though. Okay. Straight sword imbued with the strength of lightning. Okay, so is it a lightning weapon? Well, it doesn't say that it is. Oh, but it is a... It scales with faith. Okay. This featureless longsword contains the very power of the sun, perhaps it a relic of one-sided adoration. Oath of Sunlight. Raise the sword aloft when praising the sun to boost attack and damage absorption for self and allies in vicinity. The Warriors of Sunlight are cooperators from an ancient age. Okay, so they couldn't resist putting that in there. But it's from an ancient age, but it's still around today. Kind of. I mean, they have the statue right over there. That's fine. It's all good. It's all good. So we can fall here, and that would probably hurt a lot. Or fall from here and probably hurt still a lot, but not quite as much. And I guess we'll do this one. Okay, yeah, that wasn't so bad. That explains how they got this. Alright, so then... Run back up this way. I may have to teleport to that other one if I die. I'm not gonna challenge it just yet. I wanna go over in there and kinda see what's going on. Okay. They're clever, they're trying to get you to walk in. Praise the enemy horde. Can I see? I see there's a bloodstain. And I see messages, but I can't see. I saw something. What is that? It looks like a spider or something. I don't know. Maybe it's a cross between the armored spider and like from Demon Souls and the Bed of Chaos or something. Hard to say. I am gonna check it out. We have a door over there. I was just thinking back to like the room across the way with the multiple exits, and we did take them. Okay, that is not a mimic. Rusted coin. No monster ahead, you're right. Titanite scale. There are a lot of chests. Like, a lot. But now that, is that an elevator? What is that? Looks to be an elevator. What's in here? Ring ahead, time for right. Oh, this feels like a trap of some kind. I mean, it usually is. And okay, so that's I see the enemies, I see the item, and I guess we fall from here, maybe. I'm not yeah, that's a hell of a fall. Is there like happiness? Red Tearstone. Oh, okay. Instead of defense, attack. A lot of people like this. Boost attack when HP is low. A ring set with large rare Tearstone jewel. Temporarily boost attack when HP is low. The stone is said to be a tear of mourning of the goddess Kaitha. And of course, tears are always more beautiful near death. Yeah, those, the people that just dodge, like they go no armor, two-handed giant club, whatever. I mean, they're not getting hit, so they're always very happy about, anything that buffs attack damage. And since they're never getting hit, at least that's the point. Is there no switch? Does this go to the boss? Like, what's happening here? Be wary of finger. Yes. There are plenty of videos out there of people getting pulled into gears and machines and stuff. I don't want to do it. But let's, wait, hang on. What was that? Really? It's not gonna move? Contraption does not move. Well, maybe that boss over there is not an optional boss. You know, my first thought upon seeing this elevator, or at least specifically the contraption, right, and the gears on the side, is, right, the one right before the False King, Alant, in Demon Souls. Okay. It is time. It's time to stop, but we will not. Not just yet. I want that. I want that item. Yeah, you have to fall there. That's the only option as far as I can tell. But... gradually, I don't have anything that changes my, like, fall, right? Maybe. I mean, I think dexterity is involved in fall damage. What we can do is, like before, use one of these. Ah, man. Okay. Of course, the last time I did that was in that elevator, and had I not landed on the middle bar, it would have killed me. I'm certain of that. So, they lie. They lie, just a little bit. Alright, we'll, oh man. Well, we'll figure this out real fast, I suppose. Do I need to land on that middle piece? Let's try aiming for this. Okay. I'll take it. That counts. Watch this be like nothing. I mean, I'm hoping for an Estus shard. Kaitha's chime. And then there's something below still? No, not really. You know, I'd be willing to bet that some of these things, kind of like in Dark Souls 2, have special properties they don't tell you about, which is annoying. Oh, this requires intelligence also. Sacred Chime blessed by Kaitha, Goddess of Tears. Rare even amongst Karim clerics. Affected by intelligence, a rare thing for miracle catalysts, and also agreeable with miracles that lean towards the dark. Its existence is concealed in the name of the Archbishop. I'm not drunk enough. I'm not drunk at all, actually. I haven't drank anything. Its existence is concealed in the name of the Archbishop. I'm Archbishop. As it is anathema. Okay, I finally got that out without slurring my speech or getting a lisp or anything. So we have that now. And I don't really want to jump down there and fight those two guys and then fight my way out there. So we will just... can I just use this thing from here? Handy. Okay. That's right. Okay. No, that's not the one. That's the one past all of the Lothric Knights. We would want to go to... this one. Well, for now we'll go to Firelink. Invest more in my shield. Because, you know, I'm not quite sure what I would do with the other scales. And then see if we can get another level. What needs smithing this day? I will tell you. Oh, and all the crest items are twinkling titanite. And that doesn't even... It doesn't even buff stability or anything. Oh, okay. Every couple levels, I suppose. You know, that's okay. What about this? Titanite chunk. Meh. Oh! We never looked at the,
Pretty, me Lego.
We never looked at the sniper. You know, crossbow. Long-range heavy crossbow used by Kareem snipers. Its lengthy base makes aiming difficult, and accurate usage requires a trained, dexterous hand. And you can tackle with it. Which makes sense, because it's more of a... I mean, it's one-handed, right? Okay. The Shield of Want is upgraded a little bit. Then we need another 7,000. Is that what that is? Okay. So I will use... No, this is 8. What is this? 3? 5. Okay. Just need a 2, which is probably maybe one of these. Okay. Perfect.
Welcome home, Ashen One. Speak thine heart. Very well, then Tuthaken.
Okay. Yeah, that's fine. We'll get endurance to 30.
Farewell, Ashen Mace.
Mayst thou peace discover. Still missing one throne. Okay, so first... We still have a few more minutes. And I suspect the... I suspect the elevator's at the top. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to run for it and pull the switch or whatever. And then probably run back. You know... Oh, he's active. Oh, maybe I can wait. Maybe he won't see me. He didn't see me, which is weird, but that guy did. I was gonna say, man, is the elevator coming? Later. Bye. You know, I guess we can try the boss. Why not? Just to kind of get a glimpse. With my striped pants. So, going in there, the elevator wouldn't work, and I assumed it go, well, it must go up, because that was where the elevator shaft was. Okay, let me take some coffee. And, we'll either get killed or we won't. Those are our two options. Okay. So, big dude, angel, dragon slayer armor. Okay, well that explains the lightning stuff. And I'm dead, aren't I? Yes. Okay, so kind of looks like Ornstein's armor a little bit. I mean, that's the name. Let's try that again. This time, you know what? The stability on this is higher. Maybe it's just worth it. Whatever, I could've. You know, I could've sat at the bonfire. Well, at least they're nice. You know, they're not making me fight that dude. They're just making him walk straight that way while I wait for the elevator. I was gonna go with the shield. Oh, that's interesting. Look at that. There's like shield or crests on it or something. I can't really make them out, but it looks like different crests of some kind from presumably different houses or, I mean, if it's the throne or the shield of want, I would assume it's the, you know, all the different crests for all the different, like Vendrick and probably all the DLC lords as well. And maybe the crest for this one. There's my souls, by the way. All right, let's try one more time. Dragon Slayer armor. Oh. How's he gonna change his pattern up, I wonder. Oh, here he goes. Okay, that'll do it. Oh, and that would have killed me too. Whoa, whoa. Okay, so. Okay, that hurts. And okay, this is where the camera thing was. The camera was messing me up there. And then that, of course, doesn't help. The big slam. It's, you know, it's like a weird cross between, Ornstein and Artorias. So, yeah. And of course, you know, the shield is more, I wasn't even really holding it up for most of that. It was more just, if I need to, you know. Let's stop here. Level 88 with my sweet hat. Even though the sun's fading, it's important to, you know, proper skin protection, because you don't want to get cancer at the end of the universe. Also, just about everything in that world would kill you way faster than cancer would. So, there's that. But seriously, guys, thank you so much for your time and attention. I really do appreciate it. I really hope you guys are enjoying these videos. I'm having fun, even though I'm, you know, frustrated and complaining sometimes. It's, I'm still having fun. It's all good. But yeah, any questions, comments, concerns, feedback, critical, whatever, good, bad, indifferent, let me hear it. What is your guys' unique positive moment for today? So for me, it's actually, I made this stuff called Coquito. I guess it means little coconut in Spanish, and apparently it's a traditional Puerto Rican Christmas drink. It's considered like the coconut eggnog, even though it's, well, I mean, you know, there's egg in it, and there's condensed milk, so it could be very similar. But so how you make it is you take two egg yolks, or at least this is the recipe I used. Two egg yolks, a can of sweetened condensed milk, and then you want to double that amount of coconut milk. So one can of sweetened condensed milk, and then two cans of approximately the same size of coconut milk. And then basically one of the coconut milk cans full of rum. And that, you know, you can add vanilla. Add a bunch of vanilla extract as well, because that makes it taste better. And then, you know, stick in a blender and blend. And then you're good to go. You know, serve it. It gets you pretty toasted. Pretty toasted. But I would recommend either, if you're going to make that whole recipe all at once, split it into two batches, or add the rum afterwards, because, like, I have a pretty good size blender, and it was, like, right to the top. You know, so when I started blending, it was, like, spilling over and stuff. It wasn't, you know, I'd recommend figuring out a way around it, but that's, you know, that's just my recommendation. You don't have to follow it. But that's my unique positive moment. That stuff is good. I recommend you try it. And, hopefully your unique positive moment for today is just as good, if not better. Hopefully better, of course. I hope to see you guys next time, where we will die plenty of more times to the Dragon Slayer armor, I am certain. Hopefully not too many, though. You know, I want to see what that angel thing is, and what is so special about that one? You know, why is it chilling with the armor? I don't know. We'll find out. Maybe. Maybe not. But I hope to see you guys next time. Until then, guys, take care.